Maybe 3 years in the making. You know, back when I came to the district, one of the goals that I originally had was that I wanted to work alongside the community, members of the district, members outside in our Edgewood community, and really look at creating a space where young men could come and receive a quality, well-rounded, and comprehensive education that would give them a space where they could learn not just the academics of school, but also understand what it's like to be in a space to ultimately develop into a high-performing young man and eventually man of his household, eventually. You know, that space I have in my journey seen many schools where young men are given an opportunity to really just learn from other young men that are going through the same journey in life, alongside teachers that want to be in that space and teach young men. And so 3 years ago, that conversation started, and today has really been a labor of love in just getting here. When I came 3 years ago, we talked about creating a space, a portfolio district here in Edgewood, that would allow our schools to each have a purpose for why they exist, whether it's board too. I don't see any of our board members here today, but I do want to acknowledge the board because the work we're doing is innovative, you know, especially in the context of our district and the journey of our district. But I want to thank those for allowing me and supporting me and working alongside my senior leadership team in creating this space. Locally, I also want to thank Jeffrey Ms. Franco's not here, Mr. Uribe, all the hands that had to come together. This bee is going to get me here. It's okay. I have Benadryl. All the different work. Today.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hernandez. More than a decade of experience as an administrator and as a consultant of IB programs at public and private schools. So now I welcome to the podium Ms. Davis.
I'm grateful to be with you today and to be included in this special ceremony. This is a wonderful and special school and community. You have a rich history. The TCIS board and staff are honored to join this community. As your managing partner, We are thrilled to work with you to provide an IB education for your amazing. Today, we are making these promises to you. To the teachers and staff, we promise to provide IB training and TCIS support to help you become an outstanding IB educator and join that family of IB educators that truly extends around the world. To the administrators, to work every day to create a world-class exemplary school. To the community partner organizations, we know you are deeply committed to these children and their school. We appreciate all you have done for them. We look forward to getting to know you and to become your partner in supporting this school. To the parents, we promise to love your children as you love them and to provide an education that helps them reach their dreams. To the students, we promise to get to know you and to love you. We will work every day just for you. You are why we are here. Now, I am honored and delighted to celebrate the opening of the Roy Cisneros Leadership School for Boys. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ms. Davis. And we continue talking about the power of partnership and the reason why our students, they are the reason we commit ourselves every day towards reaching our goal of developing successful global citizens. The person who is the leader of Roy Cisneros Leadership School for Boys is our head of school, a principal, Mrs. Ida Nunez. Ida Nunez is the proud head of school for Roy Cisneros. She holds a bachelor's degree from Texas A&M Corpus Christi, a master's degree from St. Mary's University, and a master's in educational administration from Concordia University. She has over 13 years of experience in education in the San Antonio area. During her experience, Mrs. Nunez has launched strong dual language programs, improved campus academic performance, and led several campus clubs and initiatives, partnering with students, staff, parents, and the community to provide a high quality and engaging educational experience. As a first generation graduate, she believes that all students have potential and that it is the job of educators to tap into their strengths. Her goal is to empower her students to become leaders who embrace learning and the world around them. Please help me welcome Mrs. Ida Nunez to the podium.
Okay, good morning, and thank you for the introduction, Sabina. I am honored to serve as a head of school principal here at Roy Cisneros Leadership School for Boys as we celebrate our official transition. I'd like to thank our students, our parents, who we have several here today. I would like to thank our Edgewood ISD School Administration, our superintendent, school board, and our partner, Texas Council for International Studies, TCIS, for supporting the work that we do here at Roy Cisneros every day. I'd like to give a huge thank you to all of the staff here who works day in and day out to do what is best for our students, for our leaders. They work very hard on collaborating, lesson planning, and continuing to set the bar high to increase student achievement. Roy Cisneros Leadership School for Boys becoming an international baccalaureate world school. That is our goal, our vision, to be there in 3 years. Currently, kinder through second grade are third, fourth, and fifth grade, who are co-ed boys and girls. So each year we will continue that transition of adding another grade level to single gender until 2027, when all grade levels will be complete. I'm thrilled to be here with all of you today to celebrate our students. They are why we do what we do. Through the partnership that we have with Texas Council for International Studies, TCIS, We are providing the International Baccalaureate Curriculum, IB for short, to all of our students, kinder through fifth grade. IB encourages advanced learning, it promotes learning experiences, and teaches our students how to think critically and ask questions. This is exactly what our students need to be successful in life, and we're really proud that we're able to offer that to our students. They are at the forefront of what we do and how we teach. In June, the staff revised our vision statement, like I said, to become an IB World School. In addition, the staff developed and rewrote, I'd like to share that with you now. We are empowering and nurturing confident leaders that are prepared to interact with a diverse global community, approaching the world with voice, choice, and ownership. And our mission statement, it's powerful. It's powerful because this is what we are giving back to this community, to our community. We are empowering, we're nurturing, building our students to be confident leaders, and they will be prepared to interact not only within their local community, but also within a diverse global community. We want them to be ready to make an impact on the world when they graduate from all here to do what is best for our kids. And I would also like to thank Ms. Teresa Myers, the mayor's senior policy advisor, for coming and representing our mayor. So thank you so much for joining everyone and being a part of the history in the making that we have at Roy Cisneros Leadership School for Boys. Thank you. I'm honored to introduce to you, we have a student speaker, Persephone Garcia. She's in Ms. Celestina's fifth grade class. She will be reading an essay that she wrote on the IB learner profile attributes and what she likes about IB so far.
I love the emote experience.
Thank you so much, Persephone. That was great. We now have Victoria in Ms. Martinez's fourth grade bilingual class, who will be reading you an essay that she wrote on what an IB school means to her.
Estar en una escuela IB te ayuda a usar tu esquema. Una esquema es una parte de nuestro cerebro. En una escuela IB el estudiante está aprendiendo a ser reflexivo, ser independiente, a trabajar en equipo y a tener mayor conocimiento. Una escuela IB prepara a los estudiantes para resolver problemas. Para ser un buen líder tienes que tener una buena actitud. También tienes que escuchar a las ideas de otras personas. Y tienes que ayudar a los demás para que ellos puedan ser líderes y ellos lo enseñen a los demás.
Thank you so much, Victoria. Great work to you both. We can't wait to see what you do in the future and be proud of what you just did today. Now I'm excited to introduce to you Mr. Chavarria, our music teacher, along with our second graders who will be singing What a Wonderful World.
Good morning.
Another round of applause. Yay. You did an amazing job, and we're so proud of you. So at this time, we would like to start our ribbon cutting. If we could please have Dr. Hernandez, TCIS, Mrs. Nunez, Ms. Benavides, our school board members, Ms. Teresa Myers, the mayor's senior policy advisor who is in attendance representing the mayor's office today, and some other special guests to join us for the ribbon cutting.
Is this going to be good enough? Because we're going to be, yeah. Oh, sorry. Ooh! I'm going to get in front real quick, okay?
And the girls.
You do when you move it off to the side, so she can get there. Here, just that people are going to. Mm-hmm. I can't see if it's straight.
It's good enough, I'd say.
Okay, yeah, we're on a time constraint. There?
Even more.
What do you mean?
Oh, yeah, just don't get those white things in there. I think that's good.
Victoria, Persephone.
Okay. Yeah? I think that.
Yes.
All the pressure's on you.
Shall I open?
Oh, no, I'm going to take a quick picture, okay? 3, 2, 1.
Right. We're actually, if everyone could move over here, we have a surprise for one of our supporters. If we can all make our way this way.
Okay.
We are really excited. For more than 20 years, we have been partnering with Ed with IIT, and we're very excited not only to be a part of today and also to be a little longer, but also want to thank the Frankie and Seth Youth Literacy Club, because without them, we would not be able to be providing these little offers all over San Antonio and including the Ed with IIT. So we want to thank all of you for being here. We want to thank them for their partnership. And of course, we are so excited to continue to help grow you in San Antonio. So thank you.
One more right here, guys. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1.
Perfect.
Thank you, everyone, so much. Thank you, Isaiah. And now, if you would want to join us, we have.
Thank you.